Your body has trillions of cells in it, including web-like neurons in our brains that help us think, bundles of muscle cells that power our movements, and electricity-conducting cells in our heart that help pump blood around. But if we rewind far back enough, they started out from the same thing. The point where they decide what to be is described as noisy. But how do they decide? Just like how people experiment with different trends and explore different types of music when they're young, our cells go through a bit of an identity crisis. I mean, I dabbled a bit in a suburban punk phase when I was younger. There's a point where our cells are deciding whether they want to be a skin cell or a heart cell. At one point, everyone was just a tiny single cell called a zygote, or the fertilized egg. The cell, which is about as wide as a strand of hair, then divides into a few more identical cells, and eventually some of these cells begin to deviate from their neighbors and take on new identities. A new study probed deeper into individual cells in mouse embryos just as those first few differences start to happen. This is like when the cells have been asked what they want to be when they grow up. At this point, the activity in the cells is described by experts as pretty noisy, like the cells are throwing one last molecular party before they commit to the high-minded life of a brain cell or submit to their future in the colon. This decision point isn't super clean, and even though it's deemed noisy, it isn't actually sound. It comes in the form of excess and seemingly random transcription of DNA. If you think of DNA as the set of instructions, like a lesson plan your teacher writes on the board, each cell only copies out the instructions that are specifically relevant to its functions. For example, a light-sensing cell in the eye would copy parts of DNA that instruct it how to make proteins that can sense light. But a blood cell wouldn't need those genes. Normally, each cell type has a characteristic pattern of gene expression. But during the noisy time, all of the cells are filled with random bits of RNA, like a big mixer. Then they settle down, and they pick just the genes they'll end up needing. Understanding this process has been a long time coming. Scientists have been speculating that cells might have this noisy time for a while. But it's been difficult to observe experimentally until recently. Since cells are so small, and they contain millions of bits of information, it was difficult to get enough material from one cell, so we just sampled them by the handful, but this means we missed the subtle patterns and individual differences between cells. Now, a new technique called single-cell RNA sequencing lets scientists read out which parts of DNA are actually getting copied to be used by individual cells. It's like we're reading their little minds and seeing what they want to be. Based on this new information, it's thought this bursting of transcriptional noise gets the cells ready to receive different instructive cues from their surroundings. But there might be other hidden signals in the noise that we haven't quite made out yet. More research is needed. But thanks to these more sensitive techniques, scientists are discovering new subtypes of cells every day and slowly getting a better understanding of the road from fertilized egg to the trillion-celled masterpieces that we are today. Thanks for watching, subscribe for more videos, and if you want more examples of cells partying, check out Julian's video here about how the blood-brain barrier is like a bouncer. One last bit, noisy bursts were observed twice in mouse development, once at the first cell fate decision when 32 cells decide to be an embryo or support structure, and again 3 days later as they specialize further. Thanks for watching.